Living like a local here in Camiguin has led me to experience the wonderful flavors of the island. From the salty bounty of its pristine waters, to the tangy, earthy goodness of this no pollution, no pesticide, and no filter island paradise.
I love how pure honey looks.
So I think it's the perfect time to get acquainted with the sweet side of Camiguin. Over here, it's almost impossible not to feel a connection to the island. I see in the locals a beautiful connection to their island home.
Oh, that was good.
I see it in the way they care for the environment and their neighbors. It's plain to see in their sense of respect for their past. These ancestral homes, so well preserved and standing tall, are stunning to see. Some of these were built in the late 1800s up to the 1930s and give us a fantastic glimpse into old Camiguin. The number one thing to do here in Camiguin is to hang out at any of its nature spots. And there are certainly plenty to choose from. One of them is Katibawasan Falls. Now, even for a non-hiker like me, this place is perfect. The trek is short and comfortable. The view stunning, and the locals welcoming. Come for the waterfalls, but make sure to stay for merienda. Right outside is the stall of Tatay Glicerio and his daughter Juliet, where they serve a most interesting snack.
Living like a local, tip number, 75, is to make sure you try the local delicacies. Now, this is what they call kiping, and it goes through somewhat of a tedious process, right? First thing you have to do is to grate your cassava, and then afterwards, you roll it out really thinly into a nice even circle. And then afterwards, you have to steam it for about maybe a minute, and then you sun dry it for about 15 to 20 minutes. And then you have to fry it for 1 minute. And then they have this beautiful latik or coconut jam right on top.
In the most typical of fashions here in Camiguin, Tatay Glicerio and Juliet grew and harvested most of these ingredients themselves, making the kiping truly local and personal.
Let's give this a test. Oh, yeah. Maximum crunch factor. And you know it's good when there's no clean way to eat it. The messier it is, the better it is. Oh, yeah. It's not too sweet because, again, they just used cassava. No sugar, no anything. And it's basically a blank canvas, so it lets the coconut jam really shine. And I can already imagine like putting, condensed milk on this, chocolate syrup, cheese even, garlic yogurt sauce. I mean, the possibilities are endless. This is definitely one of those local delicacies that you can't miss. But I'm on the hunt for more. So I'm gonna finish this and keep on going.
Whoa! Just keeping it real, guys. But sorry, couldn't resist. I continue my quest for more sweets, and so I head to another famous local delicacy here in Camiguin.
You know, everywhere and everyone I ask, everyone swears by this. So, gotta come here and try. This is Torones de Mani, and they've been around for years. Since 1920, so you know, these guys know what they're doing.
La Salud's Torones de Mani is one of the island's can't-miss snacks. I say this with a great deal of confidence because the Torones, it hasn't changed in almost 100 years. How's that for a time-tested recipe?
Mmm. No, that's nice. When you bite into it, there's a real crunch to it, but then the inside, nice and chewy. really strong peanut flavor, so they're probably using a lot of peanuts, which is always a good thing.
Third generation owner Tita Rita is kind enough to show me their production area. Each torrones is expertly made by hand. The wrappers, called barquillos, are made in these classic barquilleras, the very same ones her Lola used in the 1920s. The peanut filling, meanwhile, features Camiguin honey, and it gives the torrones its distinct flavor. Local, classic, and delicious. Both the chef and the kid in me are happy.
You know what I love about this? The peanut starts to stick a little bit to your teeth. It reminds me a lot of my childhood. We used to have a lot of these at home as well. Ah, these are good. And I think I can use them in dessert as well. So you know what? I'm gonna get another one. Ate pabili pa po ng isa. These are gonna be great in dessert. Add an element of crunch to them and some sweetness. It's not too sweet. Oops. Here it is.